I want a fucking
gold pop
right fucking now.
Grumpy nerd, deep face reviews. Grumpy nerd, brutal honesty too. Grumpy nerd, driving Grumpynation. Grumpy.
What's up, Grumpynation? I am back today with a, how should we put this? A review of the GameStop Funko mystery box from Black Friday. I'm just going to go ahead and say it right now. I'm going to put this little warning here. This will not be kid-friendly, guys. So, take the kiddos out of the room. Alright, guys. So, most of you know, if you are Funko Pop collectors, that GameStop had a Black Friday mystery Funko box. It was supposed to have all GameStop exclusive Funko Pops with the chance at a gold version of each pop as well. Now, I don't even want to get into how much bullshit this whole thing was, but it was so ridiculous. So, I'll just give you a quick story. So my wife went to GameStop at 5 a.m., picked up two boxes at a mall at the GameStop. Meanwhile, about 4 hours later, I, in another town about 40 minutes away, maybe an hour away, picked up two boxes as well. Now, between the times that we bought the boxes, she told me that she opened two boxes and got two of the same pop. It's understandable, it happens, right? But some things were missing out of the box, so she took it back and replaced it with another box, which, guess what? Same thing. So, here's my issue. I drive 40 minutes away. I pick up two GameStop boxes. I noticed that the stack of boxes behind the counter all had tape that was either ripped, like this one is, or it was stretched out so you could actually lift it up about that far and see inside of it, okay? That means that, I mean, every box, okay? I'm talking about 15, 20 boxes. My wife said the same thing about her GameStop. 20 boxes, they all look like they had been tampered with. Now, I've talked to three GameStops, the two that I went to buy the boxes and a separate one that I went to actually today. The guy got super defensive about the tape and said that they came that way. They all came that way. Okay, sure. I've also heard stories of people overhearing GameStop employees say that they had gold, that they had picked up the gold pops and they were just lucky enough to find them. It's crazy. So the whole store is buying 50 Batmans, yet the two employees that work there somehow got all gold pops. It's pretty crazy. GameStop, you fail. You fail. This is such bullshit. People are spending money. Some people were buying 9, 10 boxes. 10 boxes, okay? 10 boxes getting 8 of the same pop. It is complete shit. I would love to have my money back, but it's okay. I went ahead and emailed GameStop, as I'm sure a lot of people did, and it's probably not going to do anything. The bottom line is that this whole idea was cool, but Funko and GameStop failed at how they packed the box. They could have cellophane wrapped the box. There could have been a million ways that they did this where it wasn't super shady. So it's weird because every GameStop said, no, we didn't touch the boxes. We didn't even look in them. We didn't touch them. They came in like this and we're just giving them out. It's just luck of the draw. Okay, and I do know people that got gold pops, and that's totally awesome, and I don't even care that I didn't get a gold pop. I could give two shits about it. The point is that every box that I've seen, and I'm talking about probably 60 boxes now, were all tampered with. Every single box was tampered with. I'm not letting people touch the boxes, then how are they tampered with? Are they really being shipped like that? I highly doubt it. So, without further ado, let's check out my shitty boxes. Yep, there it is, guys. Four Batgirls. Yay! Four Batgirls. Alright, so the point is, again, I understand that there is a chance that I could get four Batgirls. There's also a chance that I could get six Batgirls. It's highly unlikely that I would get six Batgirls and two employees of GameStop would get two gold pops. I mean, it could happen, but I highly doubt it. So, luckily for me, I found a couple YouTubers that I trust and like, and we're gonna do a couple trades, and three of these Batgirls will be with somebody else who didn't get the Batgirls, which is awesome, and that definitely is cool that it brings the community together. People are able to trade, and I've heard of people trading in line and stuff like that. Totally cool. But it doesn't erase the fact that this whole thing is so shady. It's the shadiest promotion I've ever seen. Now, to be honest, I don't even want to give GameStop any of my money ever again. They can take their pops and shove them up their ass. All their shit. All their dorbs, all their pops. Fuck them. I don't care. I don't want their stuff anymore. So, thanks a lot for that, GameStop, because you saved me a bunch of money. Let's talk about the rest of the stuff in the box. Now, I feel like reaction figures, I don't get them, and I know some of you guys collect them. I just don't get them. I don't understand them. They're so cheesy. They're the cheesiest things ever. But aside from that, in some of my boxes, the reaction figures were actually opened. So if I actually cared about reaction figures and collected them in package, again, here we go. Broken packages. The figures are missing. One of my boxes was completely open with no figure in it. So it's pretty lame. The whole situation is lame. The other stuff was filler. So reaction figures, a pin, and a pocket pop. Don't really care too much about any of that stuff. And I don't think many people did. So basically you spent 20 bucks on a pop that you supposedly can't get. Now hopefully Funko will stick to their guns and not release these pops anywhere else besides this GameStop box. So I got this. That's cool. Nice Breaking Bad figure. Oh wait, it's not in there. It was open. The only reaction figure that I actually liked was this one. Ruby Rod from The Fifth Element. Super awesome. Love that movie. This figure's actually pretty funny. But again, I don't get these figures. Tomorrowland. Dave Clark. Don't care. Another Heisenberg. And Karate Kid. I mean, can you see how cheesy these are? These are so cheesy. Now, this is the Karate Kid karate uniform, and I don't know if that's rare or not. I don't really care. And then another Heisenberg, and yet another Heisenberg. This is the one that's open. I got three Heisenbergs, and I've got Gus Fring. So that's that. As far as pocket pops go, I got two Denariuses. Actually, I got three Denarius. I don't know where the other one is. And an Elsa. Don't care about that either. And the pins, I got three Batmans and a Loki. So three Batmans and a Loki. Alright, so basically I got the same box over and over again, with, you know, a little variation, but not much. So I decided that the pops, or the pocket pops, and all the reaction figures, I'm just going to donate to Toys for Tots. I don't know if Gus Fring is the best reaction figure to donate to Toys for Tots, but that's what's happening. So all that stuff, everything that was in this box is except for the pops, is going to Toys for Tots. So that is my mini review of these GameStop boxes. It just doesn't make any sense, guys, and I just don't understand how it is possible that every Funko box in every GameStop, the tape is tampered with, and yet every employee says, no, we didn't touch them. We haven't even looked at them. That's the way they came. It's so shady. It's really upsetting. Like I said, I emailed GameStop. I'm sure I will never hear back from them, and hopefully I'll email them this video and they can see what an absolute shit show this whole thing was. So, guys, I'm okay with Batgirl. I like Batgirl. Not for Batgirls, but I do like Batgirl, so I'm not too upset. I just think for people who are really excited about these boxes, I think the whole thing was just real crappy, and I'm bummed out. I'm bummed out for everyone. Like I said, I don't really care too much as far as the pops that I got, but I do think that the whole thing is pretty shady. So, anyways, guys, if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you have not, and again, leave me some comments below. Let me know your experiences with this whole thing, and maybe I'm crazy. Maybe I'm crazy.
Grumpy Nerd, geek face reviews. Grumpy Nerd, brutal honesty too. Grumpy Nerd, try the Grumpynation. Grumpy.